Hello all, this is the next video with reference to the previous one that was about how to get started with Moodle, and you saw the process of sign up, that how to get sign up in. Next we'll be dealing it how to create a course in Moodle, but prior to that we have to understand that why we are creating a course, and that is the most important thing, because many get confused that obviously we are dealing the subject in the classroom, then why we need to create same course online. So think for a minute and come up with a solution or idea that why we create such courses. So obviously many a times it happens that while delivering a lecture in front of audience of 60 or 120 or maybe 240, we as a teacher are not confident that whatever we are delivering is reaching up to the end or to the all audience. So we try our level best, we try to implement several active learning methods in the classrooms, then also we see some kind of results which are not matching up to our expectations. So what ultimate solution is that? That is e-learning. In that e-learning you will be designing the same course which you are going to teach in the class, you are designing same or putting it into the online module. In this online module you will be giving them additional information related to particular topic or particular chapter or unit, so that a student can explore many field or many areas related to particular topic. Because in this era of technological advancements, we cannot limit the student particular to a circle, that they have to walk in that circle only. So we have to give them enough amount of relevant data. See, data can be of two types, mass data, another one is relevant data. So we cannot indulge them in mass data perception, we have to give them relevant data which are enough for them to understand the concept and to explore the concept. So that is the most important thing. For that reason only we are creating e-courses or e-learning courses, and with that help also we can conduct quizzes, we can see how they are performing, we can check the assessment, we can see the grading systems, grading policies, lot many parameters are there. But next we have to see that how to create a course in Moodle. So we'll be seeing, or we have already gone through this, that you already logged in into the account. Now you'll go into the site administration. In this site administration you'll be going to the courses, courses, manage courses and categories. In this you will be creating a course. In this create new course we will be giving name, for example design, design of machine elements, then we will be going to giving some short name DME, course category that is miscellaneous. Course visibility is obviously its show and course started, you can give the started and date. If you are not going to give them end date, you can give. By default it is showing 1 year. I am actually disabling it right now. Course ID number, that is something 509. You can can give here some one line or one paragraph summary also that this course deals with the design of various machine elements subjected to different loading conditions. So this is just an example that how you can create a summary. This is files, for example, you want to upload your syllabus, you can drag and drop here. There are different course format, appearance, files, uploads, completion tracking, groups. In groups, you can create group mode also. If you are having a batch of 60 students, you can split it into two parts. That can be 30-30. It's faculty's or it's teacher's wish. Role renaming, tags. So there are different things are there in course format. You will be seeing topic format, number of sections. This is by default. You can increase it. If you are having 5 units, you can go for 5 hidden sections. Show all sections in one page. Show one section, one page. That is your option. So I am giving here 4. Then appearance. Force language, that there is no any particular force that you have to use these kind of language. Show gradebook to students, show activity reports. This is actually no for students. And number of announcements, that I want to create any kind of particular announcement, that can be 6 or 7, whatever you wish, but currently it is by default 5. Files and uploads, that what is the maximum upload limit, that is 100 MB. Completion tracking, enable completion tracking. Yes, now this is the most important thing, that what is completion tracking. In completion tracking, you will be seeing that how student has completed the course, all the contents, quizzes, assignments, any particular task, any individual task, group task, whatever thing is there. With the help of this, student can know that how the course is going on, or how much percentage of course he or she has completed. Then save and display. So by the end of this, you can see, okay, so this is directly forwarding me to the participants. So when I click here, so you can see here grades, topic 1, 2, 3, 4. As I've already selected 4 topics, so this is your, so I'll be clicking here. This is your subject. So yes, you can see here topic 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is your course site that you have created, design of machine elements of short name DME, that how it looks like. So this is the way it looks like, and we will be seeing in the next video how to edit the contents in it, that how we'll start it. So see you.